the Pure Off-Road OR and the Inc. Freeride series. This clip speaks about the Freeride models and the birth and development of the category, light, quiet, and clean.
So good day, everybody. Welcome to CAKEMA 2020, coming to you live from Stockholm, Sweden. I'm here with Stefan, the CEO and founder. So the Calc platform.
Yeah.
Can you explain the conceptual framework?
Yeah, basically, so the short story is that the intention initially was not to start a business, but I suddenly just got into electric motorbikes because it meant so much in terms of new and different. You know, the idea of you know, Rory, macho, aggressive, pollutive, you know, whatever. The electric technology brings something which is clean, crisp, easy to ride and all that. So I started buying electric motorbikes, and I had, you know, different people riding these at my country house. And I soon realized that it didn't matter who it was, whether it was a pro motorcyclist or, you know, a young lady for the first time riding an electric motorbike, didn't have to clutch or change gears, no noise and so forth. Getting back to me saying, hey, Stefan, this is the most amazing thing. And I started realizing that, well, this is a really interesting space and it will for sure grow due to aspects of, you know, sustainability, transportation in general, where, you know, cities are being jammed and all that. So the planets were in line. There were so many things going on at the same time, supporting the idea that this is actually, you know, going to replace combustion, traditional combustion engine vehicles in general. So from that, I started, you know, with the input from you know, my friends trying these bikes to figure what's the best kind of, you know, format for such a vehicle. And we came to the conclusion that it's all about a power weight ratio kind of equation to make sure to reduce the weight as far as we possibly could to avoid carrying around masses of batteries, for instance, which are basically, you know, burdening the whole experience. And looking at the competition, without being cocky here, because there's going to be tons of competition down the line, but, you know, most of the players out there, what they do is they just swap drivetrain from a combustion engine to an electric drivetrain, everything else the same when it comes to geometry, kinematics, sizing, and so forth. And those bikes, you know, trying to replicate the character of a gas, you know, gas bike, become extremely heavy.
Right.
While on our side, we went the other way and built super light. So this guy, which is 68 kilos, 150 pounds, half the weight nearly of a similar combustion engine, has a totally new feel to it. And we needed to start from scratch because there was not a single piece that we could actually, you know, take off the shelf and, you know, just, you know, put on our bike. So everything from extruding, you know, tubes to, you know, again, the geometry and kinematics and all that. But every little detail has been made from scratch. Hubs, rims, wheels, even the tires are specifically developed to leave a smaller footprint while running the trails out there. So in the end, we had three standard components that we're using: brake levers, foot pegs, and rubber handles. Everything else is engineered and designed specifically for this vehicle.
Wow. So how would you describe the overall experience?
Well, it's easy. I mean, it's not me, it's everyone. So the top, you know, motorcycling guys, they get back to me and say, hey, Stefan, it's like, you know, skiing powder in the woods. And it has that feeling to it. So different to a combustion engine off-road bike, which is more like a bumper car where it's accelerating and braking and all that. This is more like a roller coaster, and okay, it's not us. It's like the electric with its torque and acceleration and the way it runs. It's totally different. So it's a unique, you know, it's a new experience because it hasn't been around for that long, electric motorbikes in general,
right,
in this context. So yes.
So now onto the Freerider calcs.
Yep.
We have the OR and, yep, of course, the jet black OR Inc.
Yes.
Models. Can you explain to me the differences between the two and highlight some of the different aspects of,
yeah,
both?
Yeah, absolutely. So again, these two are, this is our initial model. It's all about, you know, exploring with respect, being out there, backcountry. The first model, which is, again, without any compromise, it's all, you know, perfected the way, you know, all the way we could take it. And, you know, at 68 kilos, it's a wonder. The suspension was developed together, you know, with Aline's potentially the best suspension manufacturer there is out there. Mm-hmm. And that has its little brother in the Ink, which is same concept basically. The suspension is a little less sophisticated. It doesn't use linkage at the rear.
Okay.
And it has a slightly more durable and heavier wheel sets to it. So that adds 6 or 7 kilos extra compared to that, which is only 68 kilos. Similar riding experience, but slightly lower price point. So right. That's the reason why we have the two.